Hello guys, this is Ravens from Digi Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 96.
Villain's annual general meeting 2021 will take place on June 24. The annual general meeting could see announcement on Jio Google 5G phone, Jio 5G service and many more, and we can also see Jio Book budget laptop. Jio 5G phone price in India is tipped to be around 2500 Indian rupees. As LG leaves the smartphone business, the company now announced the inevitable. It must shut down the payment service it launched for its own smartphones. The message is now visible on the LG Pay website. There is no concrete date for LG Pay's shutdown, but those using LG Pay can always switch to Google Pay on their LG handset. The magnetic stripe feature that LG phone supported on LG Pay would no longer be supported on Google Pay. The upcoming Sony WF-1000XM4 wireless earbuds with active noise cancellation have been leaking left and right, and now we finally get a launch date. Sony posted a YouTube live stream on its official channel for a truly silent trailer for you, even scheduled for June 9th. The event is set to begin at 1 a.m. Japan time on June 9th, which due to time difference translates to 4 p.m. UTC time on June 8th. About a month ago, Lee Jun, founder and CEO of Xiaomi, has announced that the shipments of Mi Band 6 has crossed the mark of 1 million units. Now, Xing Zhuang, the vice president of Xiaomi Group and president of mobile phone division, was posted on Weibo that total global shipments of Mi Band 6 have exceeded 3 million units. Amazfit ranks 4th in global smartwatches sales for the first ever. The news arrived from the International Data Corporation that published a report regarding global smartwatches sales for the first quarter of this year. The Fitbit lineup of smart wearable devices will soon have a snoring detection feature added to them. There will also include an enhanced noise detection mechanism that will generate data on sound activity around the device's wearer even while asleep. The Vivo X70 series will launch in India in September. The launch will be done in partnership with the Indian Premier League, which Vivo sponsors. It has already been reported that the tournament will continue in the UAE between September and October, so the info check out. However, the exact date for the launch is currently unknown. Vivo is an official partner for Euro 2020, and it has a message for you. The advertising campaign goes live today with a message, gives your phone a break and there will be a life's beautiful moments. It will air on TV in Europe, Middle East, Southeast Asia and China, as well as globally on Facebook, Instagram and in YouTube.
Nvidia announced the Apple TV app is available for the Nvidia Shield. Reports online suggested that the Apple TV app is available to Android TV users as well. The Apple TV app is listed on the Google Play Store. The iPhone 13 series rumors have appeared multiple times and will continue until the phone launch finally. Since this is a few months from now, we are bound to see new leaks and rumors making their way, and the latest addition talks about the battery capacities of the upcoming 2021 iPhones. As per the recent leaks, the iPhone 13 phones are likely to see an 18% increase in batteries as compared to the last year iPhone 12.
A Berlin resident used an improvised fishing line attached to a strong magnetic material to successfully find and retrieve his friend's iPhone 12 Pro that fell into a muddy canal. The magnetic fishing rod was able to attract the phone thanks to MagSafe, a strong ring of magnets that is built into the back around the wireless charging coil on the iPhone 12 series. There is a Nokia branded earbud or headset if you wish coming. The product which will launch as a Nokia Solo Bud Plus is a headset aimed at business folk. The device was spotted at the FCC via Nokia Mob a few days ago and now has been certified by the Bluetooth Special Interest Group. According to the Bluetooth SIG certificate, the handset was manufactured by Skywing Communication Electronics Co. Ltd.
IQ is all set to launch a new smartphone in the Indian market, and the launch event slated for June 8, 2021. It is going to come with a 64-megapixel AF main camera. It will have a GW3 sensor of 1.79 aperture. Earlier, the company also revealed that this handset will pack a 55-watt flash charging support, and it also has a 50% in just 19 minutes. Xiaomi launched the Mi 11 Ultra in India back in April 2021. However, a month later, Xiaomi is still not able to get Mi 11 Ultra units ready for sale. The company Xiaomi recently posted on Twitter apologizing for the delay. However, the brand was still unable to give a concrete date as to when Mi 11 Ultra units would be ready for sale in India. Urban Company joins IPO rush after $255 million fundraise. The Urban Company joins Zomato, Nykaa, Delivery, Flipkart and Paytm in a list of Indian startups looking to launch an IPO in the near future. Tata Sky Bing app has officially launched for Android and iOS smartphones and brings content from 10 premium OTT apps. It lets you manage content from 10 OTT apps and enables you to have a single subscription for them. The content on the Tata Sky Bing service is sourced from Disney Plus, Hotstar Premium, Zee5, Hangama Play, Eros Now and Sharamo Me, Voot Select, Voot Kids, Sony Live and Curiosity Stream. Tata Sky Bing app subscription plan starts from Rs. 149. Asus has recently launched its two new flagship smartphones in the global market, the Zenfone 8 and the Zenfone 8 Flip. However, it seems that the company is not ready to stop anytime soon, and it has been reported that Asus is working on a new device that has mysteriously spotted on the TINA listing. According to the TINA certification website, the upcoming Asus smartphone is with the model number Asus I007D. As per the report, the codename matches the device codenamed Vodka, which appeared inside the kernel source code of the Asus ROG Phone 5. Chipmakers like Qualcomm, MediaTek and Broadcom has entered the early stages of development for the next generation of Wi-Fi chips. The next generation standard is for the Wi-Fi 7 chips that will likely feature improvement over the previous generation. Nvidia just announced its latest graphics card that is a part of latest GeForce RTX 3000 series of GPUs. At the launch conference, the company unveiled the new RTX 3080 Ti and the RTX 3070 Ti. The latest GPUs arrive with improved performance and more VRAM as well. The new features that an RTX-enabled GPU offers, including ray tracing, DLSS and reflex technology. Talking about the RTX 3080 Ti first, the new card is positioned between the RTX 3080 and the top-end RTX 3090. Samsung Display has made the decision to sell ultra-thin glass to other smartphone makers. Google is the name checked in the report, which suggests that the foldable Pixel will use UTG and a flexible AMOLED panel from Samsung. It's a big day for Huawei with a plethora of software and hardware announcement. With Harmony OS 2.0 as now officially launched, Huawei announced its first set of tablets powered by its in-house operating system. The MatePad Pro 12.6 is a true flagship offering set to go against the likes of Samsung Galaxy Tab S series and Apple's iPad Pro line. There is a smaller 10.8-inch version that runs on Qualcomm Snapdragon 870 chipset, the first such Huawei device in a long while. The MatePad 11 is more affordable offerings targeting students with the same great software features found on the more expensive models and last year's Snapdragon 865 processor on the helm. Along with the MatePad tablets, Huawei also launched the Watch 3 series as one of the products launched in this event. The Watch 3 series is made up of Huawei Watch 3 and Watch 3 Pro. The Huawei wearables come with several professional health and fitness monitoring features, and on top of these features, you get ultra-long battery life. For the first time, Huawei included a high-precision temperature sensor that detects skin temperature. The watch also comes with several new features like hand-washing detection and fall detection. Users can also monitor their workout sessions as well as health and fitness parameters. And Huawei also unveiled a couple of MatView brand monitors in China in this event. Now the company is launching them in multiple regions around the world. One is a curved gaming monitor, the other is a flattened optimized for productivity. Huawei MateView GT is a first gaming monitor and it is also optimized for multimedia, so you can do video editing on it. It has a 34-inch LCD panel with a 21:9 aspect ratio with a 4K resolution and a curvature of 1500R. In the event, along with a couple of tablets, a new smartwatch and even more gaming monitors, and it took the opportunity to air a 45-second promo of its Huawei P50 series. The promo is a slow pan showing the quad camera system of an Huawei P50 Pro, concluding with a wide view of the phone and a sunset horizon. Adding a few words to the promo, Huawei shares the P50 series with a beautiful thin and light design, and they have raised the bar in terms of phone photography. However, there was no official word on when the P50 series will debut. HP has acquired Kingston Technology Company's gaming division HyperX for $425 million. HP says that the acquisition is expected to increase its profit on a non-GAAP basis. In the first full year following closing, we are delighted to officially welcome the incredible people of HyperX to HP. HyperX has built a loyal following among gamers, and we look forward to further strengthening the HyperX brand. OnePlus 9T launch is seemingly on the cards. The phone could come with a 120Hz OLED LTPO display. OnePlus 9T Pro is not expected to launch this year. Chinese display maker BOE capped off a busy event showcase at the International Display Technology Conference held in Beijing. Among the brand's latest developments, we got to see the first flexible sliding OLED display. Details on the actual panel are scarce, with BOE revealing an outer bending rate radius of 4mm and a dynamic scrolling frequency. The panel appears to have no visible seams while expanding, with its major advantage over current foldable displays. Infinix has officially confirmed that it will launch the Infinix Note 10 and Note 10 Pro smartphones in India on June 7. If we go by the teaser released by Infinix, both these handsets will be available in India through Flipkart. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.